Hello, I'm Yuri Shlipnev, president and founder of Symbirion Inc. We develop and distribute Symbior electromagnetic signal integrity software. This is a demo of how cutouts in reference plane may affect behavior of interconnects. Here is microstrip line segment, 14.5 mil microstrip, over three cutouts in the reference plane, 20 mil. Small, medium 40 mil and 80 mil large. This is example from the channel modeling platform provided by Wild River Technology and available in Symbior kit for CMP28 platform. Decompositional analysis is used to simulate this simple link. Here are five discontinuity selectors with discontinuities launch and voids, and all of them are connected with the transmission line models. This is the most efficient way to simulate signal integrity in PCB interconnects and most accurate. Today we'll take a look at the effect of the cutouts using currents and power flow density visualization and compare measured and simulated scattering parameters, TDR and eye diagrams at the end. First, let's take a look at the microstrip crossing small 20 mil void, and the signal excited at this end 50 ohm 1 volt in series and 50 ohm load on the other end. We are looking at the surface current density in amperes per meter on dB scale animation over one period of time. It's a harmonic solution. So we can clearly see that currents have some kind of disturbance in the middle and flow around. They also flow on the other side of the plane, and small currents flowing on the opposite reference plane. So if you take a closer look at the cross sections, the cross section over solid plane, the return current flows in large area in the surface of the plane, and in the area with cutout, the return, most of the return current flows on the this metal and this metal. So we can see larger current in the corners. So if you go to higher frequency, let's also take a look at the power flow here. The power flow is almost undisturbed, so all the arrows pointing along the transmission line and in the usual pattern. Our signals, basically energy of our signal propagates in some area around the strip. And the cutouts basically has some, also some, has some kind of causes power penetrating this area, interplane area. Not much, but maybe sufficient to cause some EMI problems and so on. So at high frequencies, let's just take a look at 50 gigahertz current density. Well, pretty much the same pattern. Some current flowing on the other side, not much current on the opposite plane. And power flow. And we take a closer look at the power flow in area right above the cutout. That basically shows us what's going on. And I added plane right below the cutout, and now we can see how power gets into this area. Oh, it's power. Propagation is disturbed. And if you compute power flow in the middle of the planes, you'll see that the power that gets into through this hole and doesn't return into transmission line, it basically get absorbed here by the sidewalls, or on a real board it will go and reappear somewhere and get radiated. So if you take a look at the scattering parameters of this microstrip or small cutout, you can see that reflection are relatively low to 30 GHz, and then they grow. The medium or 40 mil cutouts behavior at 5 GHz, we can see that well, it's more difficult for the currents at 5 GHz to get around, and they maintain the same kind of pattern here and distribution in cross sections. In power flow, now we can see kind of that power flows in a larger area here. And if you jump into immediately like 50 GHz, you'll see pretty much the same behavior. And also at both frequencies, at 50 and 5, we see more current on the opposite reference plane. So S parameters of this medium cutout, you can see much more reflection even at low frequencies. This is a clear effect of this cutout in the reference plane. Here's the current surface current density at 5 GHz at the largest cutout, 80 mil cutout. So this is power flow density. Well, you can see how power is dispersed in this area and gets through the hole into this interplane area. If you compute power flow right above the cutout, we can see very nice picture of how it gets around. Most of this power gets into interplane area and goes someplace else, so it's kind of unwanted signal propagation here. You can clearly see how it gets in there, and if you combine it with this picture, so what happens at 50 GHz? Current density, a lot of current going in through this plane, but it's not helping to get signal across, definitely. So it's a current density basically that all the power that is lost. And this is clear kind of explanation what's going on. Power has to travel in very spread area, and so this is power between the planes, and we can see arrows pointing perpendicularly to walls and get absorbed in there, in those walls. So what about S parameter of this structure? Well, even more reflection, and reflection goes down, but if you take a look at the insertion loss, we can see that almost half of the power is lost at frequencies like above 25 GHz. Finally, let's compare our simulated data with measurements. Measurements were provided by Wild River Technology. Evaluated quality of all measured parameters is over 99% in Symbior Touchstone Analyzer. Here we're looking at the insertion loss model versus measured. So the correlation is acceptable up to 30 GHz, considering uncertainties in manufacturing of the structure. Reflection losses are also good up to 30 GHz for port 1, and here is for port 2, I'm sorry, and this is for port 1. Phases of S parameters always has to be computed. This is group delay simulated versus measured, and this is phase delay time domain reflectometry, and this is for port 2, looking from small hole into medium and large hole. Again, this is simulated, this is measured data. And for port 1, you can see pretty much the same correlation here. Eye diagram, probably this is the least informative thing or picture here. Eye analyzer can be used to compare the parameters of two eyes. They're almost identical, and this is the least informative way to compare simulated versus measured parameters. So the bottom line here, don't cross the cuts. You can get power reflected and lost into interplane area, and that causes EMI problems. So even if signal gets through, it still introduces a lot of uncertainty. Everything here for this presentation was computed with the regular version of Symbior THD software, released 2017-02. To learn more, visit Symbirian website, see other how interconnects work demo videos in this section, and new demo videos will be coming out soon. Take a look at application notes or download and try Symbior today for 15 days. Thank you.